But we begin with this homeless camp. It's getting a lot of attention for where this is located.
Yeah, you may have seen it. If you take the on-ramp to Parker Road and I-225 West, you can see some items actually out there on the pavement.
And Fox 31's Rogelio Mares joins us live near the encampment where this is impacting budgets, cleanliness, and safety. All new tonight at 10. Rogelio.
Yeah, Eric and Jeremy, we're high above I-225 near Parker Road here. And if you look over in that direction there, you can see the encampment still as it stands right now. You can't help but take a deep breath every time you see a car go around that bend there. Any moment could be the worst case scenario for that driver and for the folks staying in those tents right now. Actually, we got one car driving by, as you see there. We talked to Colorado Department of Transportation about how they handle these kinds of issues.
Cars passing at an increasing speed, as they should, on an interstate on-ramp. It's the tents on the shoulder that present a hazard to this entrance onto Interstate 225. Most shoulders on highways like this are property of the Colorado Department of Transportation. So what does it do when camps like these crop up? A no trespassing sign is usually the first option. CDOT says they can't clear out an encampment like this without help from local law enforcement, but that is another option, done as humanely as possible, according to CDOT. Then comes the cleanup, not just trash, but hazardous waste. That comes at an annual cost of between $2 and $3 million to the state. The human cost of these encampments, the safety of the people who set them up and live there. Back in April, a man sleeping in a tent off Interstate 25 in Westminster was initially hurt, then later died from his injuries after being struck by a car. People experiencing homelessness already face a number of risks to their lives: untreated illnesses, drug-related overdoses, violence, and even traffic incidents. A group called the Homeless Death Count coordinated with The Guardian and found that homeless death rates rose 77% from 2016 to 2020. In Denver alone, that same study reported an increase in the city of 30% over the same 4 years. And these are just deaths that have been reported. The National Healthcare for Homeless Council estimates between 17 and 40,000 deaths of people experiencing homelessness each year.
Back here live, you can see the encampment still there right now, a couple of cars passing by it. We talked to CDOT and they said the best thing that you can do if you come across something like that is report it to them. That gets the process started for them to be able to clear these folks out and get that area cleaned up. We're live in Aurora, Rogelio Mares, Fox 31.